In Born to Run, Bruce Springsteen said, "This town rips the bones off your back. It's a death trap. It's a suicide rap." All I can say is if he was talking about Freehold, New Jersey, my Freehold, Bruce, you were wrong.
Now when you're feeling low and the fish won't bite, you need a little bit of soul to put you right. You got a man like you want to deal with friends, and then a little bit of soul will come your way.
Our first stop was at the intersection of Shank Road and Stonehurst Boulevard in Freehold. Most people just saw a corner, a curb, signs. But when you go back, you just think of what was once there. We had a neighborhood party, Halloween costumes. My dad was the clown. And now there's a bank. More trees. But it was there my father taught us all about how management views its employees. In 1964, Stonehurst was a single-family development with over 256 homes. Today, they would have put in 4,000 townhouses on half-acre lots, and there would be a Home Depot, a storage locker, and a Walmart. It never would have been the neighborhood it was. People had garages, they had attics, they had basements, they had a place to park their car and driveways. The Williamsburg, a luxurious two-story colonial home reflecting the best of American colonial design, containing 9 rooms, 2.5 baths, full basement, 2-car garage. And I knew all the models from way back. Then there's the Yorktown, and the Monmouth, and the Oxford, and the Salem, and the Newport. The Stonehurst that I grew up in was slightly different than this one. The trees weren't as lush, and in a way, I almost think it was better because when neighbors could see each other, they're kind of nicer to each other. There was the old house, 223 Stonehurst Boulevard. There's my grandmother, my mom. Look at the shrubs, hardly any shrubs. Same kind of setup. We planted everything. The soil was clay. And those front steps, Dad, going to work. He commuted to New York, worked at AMF, took the bus. When's the last time you saw a guy happy from work? That's when people came home at 5 o'clock. He worked for AMF, which he jokingly referred to as another mechanical failure. My dad wasn't anything like the businessmen that were portrayed in rock songs.
You better take care of business, Mr. Businessman. What's your plan? Get down to business, Mr. Businessman. If you can before it's too late. And you throw your life away.
None of those guys were. Man, they all knew each other. They went down to the Freehold Raceway, placed bets, hung out at Moore's Inn on Fridays with the moms, drank beer. They had a great time. On Friday, when the bus left the Port Authority bus terminal, all the Freehold guys were on the 520. And when that bus came out of the tunnel and hit New Jersey, someone would hold up a finger and say one. Then that same person would hold up a finger and say two. Then on three, you'd hear all the guys from Stonehurst pop open their beer cans. These were guys in their 30s. They had 2.3 kids. And they had survived the business week and were coming home for the weekend. Herb Alpert and the Tijuana Brass were everywhere. Whipped cream and other delights was played almost every Saturday night. And the parties, everyone knew each other. The living rooms, every other Saturday, someone had a party. Cigarette smoke, whiskey sours, old-fashioned scotches, martinis, Manhattans, gin and tonics, grasshoppers, Ballantine beer, every spare table at chafing dishes, saucepans, fondue pots, bowls, Tupperware bought by neighbors that contained peanuts, pretzels, Charles potato chips, Fritos, Bugles, Ramaki, Vienna sausages, pork wine cheese spread, Swedish meatballs, cheese puffs, pimento olives on a piece of cheese and salami, tuna noodle casseroles, cold cuts wrapped in cream cheese, deviled eggs, Kraft Old English cheese spreads, chop suey, cream cheese, and peanut butter and celery, stuffed cherry tomatoes and mushrooms, poo-poo platters, Jello, and glass dishes rimmed by Ritz crackers surrounding a container of clam or spinach dip. I never liked that. Man, I tell you, seeing those adults laughing and drinking and yakking and dancing to Herb Alpert, I couldn't wait to grow up. Hey, Mom, my sister Cindy, Steffi, the family dinners, the relatives coming over, the Molly Pitcher's Woman's Club, she's big on that. My mom would have some meetings. Those women used to get blasted in the living room in the afternoon. And Girl Scouts, with my sisters in tow. The result of my mother being in the Girl Scouts with my sisters, it gave me an incurable, lifelong addiction to freezing chocolate mint cookies and dipping them in milk. And the kitchen, with the latest in caloric and hot point appliances. Every Christmas, the same deal, my dad being a wise ass with his hand, and those winters with snow forts and snowballs and banging cars. The walls always so blank and empty, but the house so full. When relatives came, my mother always wanted us to take out all the jackets in the hall closet so that we'd have room for guests. And then she'd say we'd had to vacuum up everything. I said, well, why can't they just see the way we live? Why should we have to clean it up? She never bought that argument. I think everybody has one of these pictures. Relatives sitting on the couch, then the flashbulb banging off the window in the back. Like some North Star of the past just kind of guiding us forward somehow. It's amazing how relatives shape you. You don't even know it. It's like being soaked in something. You know, vines and soil pick up things. Just being around them, and you see how it changes you. You don't know how, but you know they affected you.